Welcome back here on First News. We're talking about a possible new KCI. Talk of building a new airport, picking up steam, especially this past week. The city's aviation director, Mark VanLoh, is on board. But what about the rest of the city? Good to have you back. Mayor's on board with us as well.
Yes, he is.
How come?
I think he sees the immediate short-term need to spend $1 billion of someone else's money in Kansas City and putting probably 3,000 people to work for several years.
And you say $1 billion of somebody else's money because there is the possibility of federal funding. Certainly tenant fees, airport fees would be a part of that equation.
Yes.
And probably floating some bonds as well.
Yes. That would be
in a very broad sense.
That would be paid for by the aviation department, not taxpayers.
Right. You're thinking about going from three terminals to one, again, in a broad sense.
Yes.
And 57 gates.
Yes.
From the 90 that you have right now. And is 57 enough in terms of future growth?
Well, it is for many, many years to come, probably at least 10 years. Because, again, using common use gates where multiple airlines can use the same gate. Currently, we can't do that. And then it has expansion capabilities for those years farther out.
You haven't been on board all that long. But when you looked at this job, when you looked at that airport out there, you thought what?
I thought ways we could improve it. I thought the air service was lacking. We could do a better job of getting additional airlines, additional service in here. And, you know, of course, being part of city, there's some restraints. But so far, I think we've done a pretty good job.
But did you look at this airport in kind of like a three-headed monster, thinking to yourself, the cost of heat, the cost of water, the cost to keep these buildings maintained, when they haven't been at full capacity in probably many years, true?
Yes.
And you're thinking to yourself, this can't be.
You know, I came here several years ago to discuss air service with Vanguard Airlines when I was in Cleveland. And I landed in Kansas City for the first time, and I walked in the terminals because their offices were in the terminal. And I just looked around and went, my goodness, how can they afford to operate this? Because many parts of the terminal were empty. And you start to think at the time how you could do a better job.
So a year from now, you hope to have results of this federal study,
yes.
Federally funded study,
yes.
Which will obviously give the aviation department and the city a base by which to continue this discussion. And if you were able to turn shovels today, how long of a period of time are we talking about possible construction?
If we started today, it's probably about 3 years construction time.
And $1 billion.
And $1 billion.
Yeah. Do you find that the thought of having to sell that to the community, to neighborhoods that don't have sidewalks and don't have a lot of things that perhaps nicer other neighborhoods have?
Well, this
because
money,
that's an argument that you're going to run into if you haven't already.
Yes, we have. This money is in a pot in Washington, D.C. that we've contributed into for years as air travelers. It can't go for any other use except aviation. And I wouldn't be doing my job if I wasn't standing in line in Washington to get money to come back to Kansas City. You know, Wichita just announced they're going to spend $100 million on a new terminal in Wichita, which, when their traffic is declining, and they're paying public dollars for air service.
We'll be watching, that's for sure. Mark VanLoh, the city's aviation director. Good to have you with us. Appreciate
it. Thanks, Chris.
Back to you.